And now, broadcasting from deep behind enemy lines in the occupied territory of the Socialist Republic of California, your host, former California State Assemblyman and Governor candidate, Tim Donnelly.
Hey, welcome back to the Radio Free California Network. And yes, we are live and in person here at the Radio Free California Network studios. And I don't get this. I go away for one day. And what happens? The whole world explodes. I mean, we got the president handing over permission for the Iranians to build bombs, do whatever you want, nuclearize. I sound a little like George Bush there. Go nuclear. And then we've got the Planned Parenthood. They're trafficking dead babies and selling off their parts. And we'll get into that a little bit later. And then Hillary Clinton, did I get this right? Hillary Clinton reintroduced her campaign. And I heard that the media who were present. Now you got to get this. If you're going to reintroduce your campaign, you got to come alive. You got to bring something to the table. You got to Trumpenize it, because now Trump's the standard, right? I mean, you do realize that he stole his last name from you. You're the Noskinator, but he's the Trumpinator.
I'm okay with that.
Okay, so he's the new gold standard in candidates that, because basically, if you really want to have an impact in today's political world, you got to tick people off. You got Bernie Sanders wants to raise your taxes, and he has a huge number of people that like that because they want to steal from you and I and use the government as the method of theft. And that's very popular. People want to take your money and they want to put it in their pockets. And yes, they might funnel it through a government program and call it charity or call it your, fair share of what you have to give. But that's very popular with a certain segment of the population, the socialists, the communists, the people who want the government to control every aspect of their lives. And he's killing Hillary every time you turn around. And then you've got Donald Trump, who can't do anything right, according to the media, and yet he's slamming everybody. He did a body slam on Jeb Bush, and nobody even noticed Scott Walker got in the race. Poor guy. Worst possible time is to get into the race. Because, look, if you think about this, if you're in politics, the biggest announcement, the biggest media event of your life is announcing your presidential campaign, right? It just is. So to have it almost completely ignored, yeah, the mainstream media picked up on it a little bit. He got insulted by the AFL-CIO leader, Richard Trumka. And then it was like, okay, 15 people in the race. There might as well be 57, one for every one of Obama's states. It's crazy. But here's the fascinating part of this whole thing. Are you dying in there? I mean, you are just...
I'm dying.
you what? The allergies got you or what's going on?
Yeah, when the wind picks up, I just can't see. I can't breathe.
Okay, well, if anybody has any ideas to help the Noskinator, I mean, she is in distress. It, you know what I think it is?
Don't even tell me it's my new diet.
You are eating all that healthy stuff. Yeah, look at me. I am actually trying to replace all of my energy drinks with water. I am drinking water. I don't even have any coffee today. I mean, I had some this morning, but I have no coffee here in the studio. If I start to put you to sleep, please call in and wake us up here at the Tim Donnelly Show, because who knows how this could go by taking massive quantities of caffeination out of the equation, but I have to do that for my health. So that's the bottom line. But did I tell you about this movie event I went to yesterday, a movie premiere in Hollywood?
No, I want to hear all about it.
Okay, so it was so funny. We're rolling up there. By the way, let me start this out right. As we leave the house, our trusty SUV, the Sequoia-nator, hits 400,000 miles.
Woo!
Yes. We have a picture. I'm going to post it on Facebook later. I've just been a little bit busy. And I am in the middle of doing the SB 277 referendum. I'm checking the petition. I'm answering media calls. I'm doing interviews while I'm driving, of course, not holding the phone to my head. I had my headset on. But, you know, then I'm getting texts and emails. And I mean, you can't look at that stuff when you're driving. I mean, it's deadly. So I can't. And, of course, my wife is sitting there making sure that I don't. So we get to the venue and we're driving by. It's at the Chinese Theater on Hollywood Boulevard. You know, the Grauman Theater, which is now called, I think, Dolby or Delphi Studio or something. They got some new name for it. Some corporation took it over. But it's still the same old place. As we pull up, it's red carpet. There's media. The guy who sponsored the whole thing, it's a movie called Wrong Side of Right, exposing the underside of the animal rights establishment that actually takes your money, makes you feel bad, but doesn't actually help animals, which is sickening. Anyway, we watch this guy in a cowboy hat get out of a Bentley. And that set the tone. I mean, it was like, this is going to be great, because you've got all these peckerwoods from up in the hills with too many guns coming together in Hollywood for a red carpet premiere of a movie that exposes one of the pet issues of Hollywood. So, of course, we expected protesters. There weren't any. But I decide, my wife made me wear a tuxedo, right? So don't even make any comments about that. I had to take an hour walk just to fit into the damn thing.
Thanks, Rowena.
So I decide, you know what? I saw a guy in a cowboy hat getting out of a Bentley. I'm not going in there in a tuxedo straight. So I put on my NRA hat in a tuxedo.
Oh, my goodness.
And wore it in there on the red carpet. Yes, I did. And it was great, because who do I run into but a whole bunch of gun lovers, and there were a surprising mix of people. There were an awful lot of young people. We're in line for the popcorn and all that, and
that's not in your diet.
I know it wasn't. I got a really small one, and I shared it because we hadn't eaten pretty much all day. We thought there was going to be food, but there wasn't. So we get in this line, and there's a young man there, and he sort of took command because nobody was actually pushing the line forward and getting stuff done. And so I engage in a conversation with, turns out he's an actor on the ABC program Fosters. Anyway, my kids watch it. And so, you know, we of course had to take a selfie with him. There's all these actors and actresses running around. Leah Thompson's in the movie and a bunch of other people. And I have to admit, it was exciting to see that a lot of people are waking up. We hear so much bad news. We hear so much negativity. And yes, we cover it on this show, and we will continue to. But I thought it was pretty cool that a major corporation and the owner of it, Forrest Lucas, who owns Lucas Oil, would actually do a movie to fight for what he believes in and do it right and put up real money, get real Hollywood actors involved. We are going to have the director of that movie on, so we'll be talking about it more. But it was a hoot. And I made a lot of new friends with my hat and my monkey suit. It's great. Wait till you see the pictures. Anyway, we'll have them up on Facebook. I don't know if I'll put them on the actual website, but I will put them on Instagram just so that you can make comments. And we are going to take a quick break. We will be back with a great show we've got planned for you today. Make sure that you lock in our number, 323-746-TALK.
Defending the fundamental freedom of parents to make informed decisions for their own children is a basic human right that should never be discarded. But it was. California's SB 277 denies children access to education and takes away a parent's right to choose. You don't have to be a parent to help, and only you can make a difference. Let's veto SB 277. Save the freedom of a parent's right to choose. To volunteer or donate, go to SB277referendum.com. SB277referendum.com. Do it now.
Whether you're an experienced shooter or just buying your first gun, Turner's Outdoorsman has everything you need, along with a knowledgeable and friendly staff to help you find that perfect gear for your next adventure. Turner's now has 18 locations across Southern California, including a Victorville location right on Bear Valley Road. Be sure to check out the new Archery Pro Shops in the Victorville, Chino Hills, and Pasadena locations. If you're not sure what you're looking for, you can browse and shop their selection at turners.com. Be sure to check out their weekly specials and sign up to get them delivered directly to your inbox. Turner's is where I turn for all my firearms and ammo needs. Remember to tell them Tim Donnelly sent you, and you'll get an additional discount. It's, you really appreciate a guy like Donald Trump when he calls out Obama for how poorly he has negotiated deals in the interest of the United States. And you can't find a better example, and I'm sure maybe you're sick and tired of hearing about it, but this deal with Iran has to be one of the worst deals ever struck by a president in the history of our country. He's empowering them to build nuclear weapons. That's the end result. Meanwhile, they're holding four Americans hostage. You know, I'm getting shades of Jimmy Carter. I don't know if you remember, but do you remember under the Carter administration when our hostages were there? It was during the late 70s. I believe, what was he elected in, 76 through 1980? And then we had Ronald Reagan. And the minute Ronald Reagan was elected and sworn in, the hostages were set free because they knew that Ronald Reagan meant business. Obviously, the so-called post-racial president, the president who is ultimately going to build all kinds of friends in the world for the United States. He's supposed to be this genius at negotiating, and foreign policy was going to be his strong suit. Meanwhile, all of our allies hate us. And now we've got Israel, who is coming out, and they are flat out saying that we are not going to abide by this deal. I mean, this is a major break. And the mainstream media, it's almost like they're asleep. But you're not. So we're going to take a call from Devin in Long Beach. Devin, welcome to the Tim Donnelly Show.
Yeah, hi. I'm glad I finally got to talk to you. We've talked on Facebook a few times, but I think, as much as we need to raise the flag about Obama and all the crap he's doing, because I don't think he's an idiot. I think he knows exactly what he's doing. I think he, you know, I just watched last night America Imagine the World Without Her by Dinesh D'Souza.
Oh, yeah. That's a great film, by the way.
And 2016, Obama's America. They quoted from, you know, Obama's book, Dreams from My Father. The fact is, somehow he thinks that our country, you know, has, and this is spreading like wildfire throughout all the liberal schools and the colleges, that somehow our, you know, prosperity and our well-being is built at the expense of other people that we stole from. And so now, and the thing is, our prosperity has helped other people in the world. We've gotten jobs to, you know, people in other countries. Like, hundreds of thousands of people got out of poverty thanks to, you know, the success in America. Now Obama wants to undo all that because somehow he thinks he's saving the world.
Devin, the key is that America has always represented a framework. That's all.
Yeah.
There's no guarantee of success. When you read the Declaration of Independence, it doesn't say that there is a guarantee of happiness or success.
Absolutely.
It says that the government shall protect and safeguard these inalienable rights. That is the purpose of government: life, liberty, and the pursuit, not the guarantee of happiness. And the bottom line is, your success is up to your initiative, but not anymore. The America that Obama has built, that the Bernie Sanders of the world and the Hillary Clintons of the world would like, is one where when you're climbing that mountain and when you're working your tail off and you're and you put all your capital and all your eggs in one basket and you're trying to pursue your dream and create wealth and capital for yourself, which will create opportunity for others, but you have to drag six people on your back as you climb that mountain without a rope. I mean, that's the America of today, and that's a recipe for abject failure, because it's ultimately a communist or socialist model where the government controls the means of production, the government controls your capital, you don't. They have more control over it, and they just look to penalize you every time you turn around.
No, absolutely. You know, my success, me reaching my goals, and this is every American, depends on their responsibility, them putting in the work, and people want to, it disgusts me when they, it's your white privilege. It's your white privilege. Look, you know what? Please, help me find my white privilege. I've had a struggle like everybody else, and I'm just starting to see the success of my hard work. But hey, you know what? I'll sell you my white privilege for $50,000, and I'll be better off in the end.
You're going to sell your birthright, are you?
Absolutely.
Yeah, let me tell you what white privilege is. It's very simple. White privilege. It is your privilege to write a check to the government every time you turn around. If you are successful, you get to write a check to the government if you're white. If you are, if you build something, Obama gets to take credit for it, and you get to write a check to the government and then create jobs for a whole bunch of people who wouldn't have jobs through their own initiative, but they're government jobs. That's why there's no accountability whatsoever. But your privilege, your white privilege, is you get to continually fund the activities of a government that is hell-bent on depriving you of your freedom, of your natural fundamental right to defend your own life and to practice your faith. And the bottom line is, your skin color is irrelevant. And anybody, you know, I've been thinking about this. We need to make a pact, all of us as Americans. Yeah. You know what? Everybody's racist and nobody's racist. So screw racism. There's going to be two camps. There's going to be those who whine about it and those who don't. Which camp are you in? End of discussion. Just like when Lynn Russell, the CNN anchor, the former CNN anchor, said, guns, there's no debate. I got mine. Nobody's putting a gun to your head to buy one. So shut the F up.
Yeah.
That's how we have to start dealing with this. And Devin, unfortunately, we are running out of time here, but I want to thank you for calling in. And thanks for listening to the show.
Anytime.
Where are you listening from, by the way?
I'm listening just, I'm listening from work at Long Beach.
All right. We don't want to get you in trouble at work. All right.
No, actually, I'm off work. I've already finished work, so I'm doing this.
All right.
You know, I'm done.
Good man. But, good man. Thanks for the call, Devin.
One quick thing, Tim. One quick thing.
Go ahead.
Is that me?
Yeah.
The solution is this election. We have a ton of candidates, and we're spreading things so thin. 17 to 22% people only want Jeb Bush. That means the other 78 to 83% don't. We need to figure out who our alternative to the establishment is, because Obama, they're too far to the left, and the guys in the establishment are only going to slow it down. They have no intention because they're too freaking afraid.
You think there's really 17% that would actually vote for Jeb Bush? You know what? We got to take a break. But if you're one of the 17% that's thinking about voting for Jeb Bush, please call in and entertain the Radio Free California audience. Right after these breaks, we'll take your call, 323-746-TALK. If you've been listening long to the Tim Donnelly Show, you know that we talk constantly about defending freedom and about defending our natural and inalienable rights. The Firearms Policy Coalition is a partner of the Tim Donnelly Show. But more than that, they're on the front lines every day in Sacramento and all across the state, in the courts, defending your Second Amendment right. That is a natural right that the government merely acknowledged in the Second Amendment. If you value your freedom, then you need to join Firearms Policy Coalition. Become a member. I'm a member, and I'm happy to support an organization that is doing such an incredible job. Go to joinfpc.org. The Tim Donnelly Show sent you. Or go to timdonnellyshow.com and click on the FPC link to make it easy. But whatever you do, join today. FPC.org. Hey, you are at the right place. You have tuned into the Radio Free California Network. We stream live 3 to 6 p.m. every day, every weekday at timdonnellyshow.com. You can connect with us on Facebook and Twitter. And we were discussing before the break the craziness of anyone who could possibly support Jeb Bush or Hillary Clinton, the establishment ticket. 323-746-TALK, 323-746-8255. If you're going to vote for either one of them, I would love to hear your reasons. You know, we won't attack you, don't worry. But I don't believe anyone exists who would actually vote. Let's be straightforward. You could have a real choice, right? I mean, if you could choose to have somebody who absolutely, positively, enthusiastically supported your beliefs. So if you're a socialist and you want the government to steal from others and redistribute to you, you want the government to control the means of production, you want to live in a country where the government, it's government of the government, by the government, and for the government. That's the country you want to live in. Why would you go for Hillary Clinton when you could have Bernie the Burn Sanders? I mean, that guy is tearing it up on the left because he's a true believer. Look, I bear him no ill will. I love his honesty. As a matter of fact, my dad said he doesn't like him because he's honest. He likes him because he is who he is. Right? Now, who is Jeb Bush? I don't know. Who is Hillary Clinton? Nobody knows because she won't even answer any questions. And so when she does a press conference, she's like a robot. Miss Hillary Clinton, what do you think about the war in Iraq? Were you in favor? Were you against it? Are you going to be Hillary Clinton?
There's a war in Iraq.
You know what, Hillary, I'm a little bit disappointed. You're sitting there and you're trashing my legacy, and you're out there saying that you would move to the left. I was a centrist. I brought people together. Yes, I brought too many people together. I never should have brought Monica into the relationship. But you know what? Sometimes you just got to love everybody. And I love everybody. But the bottom line is, Hillary, for crying out loud, when you do a press conference, you got to say pithy things. You got to say them funny. You got to act. I mean, just pretend that you like people. I don't just like people. I love people a little bit too much. But you're like a robot. It's hard to believe that she passed all of this political machinery that sort of vets candidates and blocks candidates and takes on candidates and tries to bury them in the back 40 when the party doesn't like what they're doing or the party can't control them. The more Hillary talks, the more that she gets out there. It's kind of like the Meg Whitman effect. At the end of the governor race of 2010, when Meg Whitman was campaigning in full steam and was dumping, like, I don't know, $1 million a day in ads. She spent a record $170 million losing the governor's race. At least I only spent $750,000. But the more she put her message out, the more people hated it. They hated it. They were focus grouping this. They were polling it. And the more they heard her message, the more they hated the candidate. And this was conservatives and undecideds. It was not liberals or leftists. And with Hillary, unfortunately, the people that she needs to win are having real issues with her. They don't know where she stands. She won't actually say anything controversial. Look, if you want to be an elected office, if you want to be president of the United States, you've got to put it out there. I mean, you can love or hate Barack Obama. That's your freedom in this country. But that guy takes big positions, and he has said, I want to fundamentally transform America. He said that himself. And now he is doing it, and he is fundamentally dismantling America one piece at a time, one executive order at a time. He doesn't need Congress to do the damage that he intends to do. And he doesn't care what anybody thinks. So it's created this incredible opportunity for someone to rise up and actually be a leader. Where are the presidential candidates? Have you heard from any of them on this business with Planned Parenthood? And if you don't know what I'm talking about, if you've been hiding under a rock, you need to check it out, because it is, I have never seen anything like it. I'm going to lay out a picture for you. So there's a woman who is eating noodles. She is sitting in a restaurant. She looks like a nice enough person. It looks like a nice restaurant. She's got a huge glass of wine in front of her. She could be one of your friends. No, people can't see that face. You have to say something on air.
I can't speak today.
Oh, my gosh. This is...
I think she's eating salad. And yeah, she has a huge glass of wine. I mean, maybe she just needed to get comfortable in order to talk about the things that she talked about.
And look, you need to go online and look at this video. It's everywhere. It is Planned Parenthood official discussing fetal organs used for research. They're basically selling baby parts, dead baby parts, aborted fetuses. And it is the language in which it is discussed. You want a heart? A liver? A lower extremity? Not a problem. These are her words.
Obviously, there's many issues with this, but the part that was probably most disturbing to me was how she was discussing how the abortions are performed, depending on which part of the fetus was wanted.
That they want to preserve.
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, so you're trying to tell me that you're going to perform abortions differently according to how and who wants the fetus.
Right.
I think that's...
No, I mean, it literally, it is, this is so shocking. Look, it doesn't matter whether you are for or against abortion. This is whether you are for or against harvesting human tissue for sale, whether you are for trafficking dead baby parts, and whether you are in support of abortions that are performed late term, where they literally will terminate the life of that baby with the sole intent of preserving one or more parts, and including the head. So they don't want to harm the head, so they basically stab it in the heart. I mean, the stuff that they're talking about, I'm not even going to go into a lot of detail on this because it is so shocking. But here is the double standard. The double standard is if Todd Akin says something about rape and abortion, which, of course, Republicans are always put to the gauntlet on abortion. So, do you support a woman's right to choose? This is not about the woman's right to choose. This is about a systematic right to butcher.
Yeah, this is
a
after
child.
The fact.
This is about butchering a child after the fact, as if somehow they were a piece of meat. And it's funny, they all of a sudden become a body. They become a human being when they're chopping them up into parts. Then somehow mythically, as they've come out. But this is something that the media has completely stayed away from. And yet, I would say that 80% of Americans, either for abortion or against abortion, whether you identify yourself as pro-choice or pro-life, you would be horrified, you would be sickened, and I'm really disappointed we cannot pull the video clip into the show because it just, the quality is not there. But I'm going to try to read you as I play the tape, and it isn't going to be easy because I have to stop and start it. But here she is, says, well, like, wow, yesterday was the first time people wanted lungs. And then, like I said, with as many intact livers as possible, people just want, some people want lower extremities too. Well, that's simple. I mean, that's easy. I don't know what they're doing with it. I guess they want muscle. And she's eating while she's saying all this. By the way, buying or selling human body parts is a federal felony according to the federal code 42 U.S. Code 274E. And the commercial trafficking of body parts from an aborted baby is punishable up to 10 years in prison and a $500,000 fine. But they have on their site, there is actually an order form. You can order. I'm not making this up. You have to look at this tape. This is completely, absolutely insane to be sitting there having a glass of wine, enjoying your dinner while you're talking about chopping up a human being, a human corpse, a tiny little corpse, into pieces so that you can sell them and continue to fund your insanity. I don't even have words for this. It just goes so far beyond the pale for me that I am sickened just sitting here talking about it, and I haven't had anything to eat recently. So anyway, we will change the subject when we get back. 323-746-TALK. We have a lot more to come up, including a conference, an Engage California 2015 conference coming up this weekend. We're going to talk about it at 4:06. So don't go anywhere. Hey, if you find yourself in my hometown of Twin Peaks, don't leave without stopping by the Grill at the Antlers Inn. It's right in the heart of Twin Peaks. They serve dinner every night. They're right there at Highway 189 and Bear Springs Road. They have the best steaks, the best sushi, No matter what you have, make sure you call ahead for a reservation. 909-336-2600. 909-336-2600. And tell them Tim Donnelly sent you.
Defending the fundamental freedom of parents to make informed decisions for their own children is a basic human right that should never be discarded. But it was. California's SB 277 denies children access to education and takes away a parent's right to choose. You don't have to be a parent to help, and only you can make a difference. Let's veto SB 277. Save the freedom of a parent's right to choose. To volunteer or donate, go to SB277referendum.com. SB277referendum.com. Do it now.
This is the Tim Donnelly Show, and if I sound a little bit hoarse, I've been talking all day on the phones, and yesterday, I was at a Hollywood movie premiere, red carpet, Chinese theater, met some amazing people, got home at 3:30 in the morning. Yeah, I love that face in there. All right, so are you feeling any better?
No.
Okay. Well, if anybody has any ideas for the Noskinator on her allergies kicked up by the winds, let us know. But I'm going right to the phones with Rick from Apple Valley, who wants to comment on the Planned Parenthood disaster. Rick, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Jim. Thanks for taking my call.
It's great having you on.
Thank you. You know, I came across this story yesterday, and I have a really active Facebook, where people often comment on political stuff I post, and nobody would touch this story with a 20-foot pole. And I don't understand what an ethical just conundrum. How can you aside from selling, you know, human body parts, but just the fact that we're looking the other way, that people are okay with aborting these fetuses that have organs that are viable for transplant, for human transplant, that are marketable. How sick. I don't even understand how this lady can sleep at night.
Well, and it's also fetal tissue. They look for the stem cells. I mean, they're looking for stem cells. That's another part of this. And look, that brings up a whole nother discussion. People are terrified to talk about something that, A, is so horrific, they don't know how to talk about it. But look, when we as a society get to a point where we can't simply identify right from wrong, where you need to wait until some leader, I'm putting air quotes here, paves the way and makes it possible for you to have a conversation, we're in trouble. We're in serious trouble.
I agree, Tim. I mean, I'm flabbergasted. Obviously, I'm sick to my stomach thinking about this story, but just, I mean, it's such a clear ethical, under any ethical system any ethical philosophy you examine, such a clear violation of any sort of ethical philosophy that it's sickening. I can't even believe when I read this story. I couldn't believe it.
Oh, I couldn't either. And I've been reading commentary on it, and the commentary is so bombastic, as it should be. We should be angry about this outrage, because look, I don't care what you think about abortion, but you're paying for this. And it's hard for me to talk about it without using cuss words, so I have my finger right on the dump button to dump myself off air if I violate that, in case the Noskinator doesn't catch me. But you are paying for this with your tax dollars, because that supports the operations of Planned Parenthood. That's the bottom line. So if you don't know what to think about it, well, think again, because you're financing the wholesale trafficking of the fetal tissue and the organs and the body parts of those innocent, tiny little souls, those children. Whether you believe they're alive or not doesn't matter, because they are a body and they are being desecrated. And this is despicable. It is a disgusting, absolutely, I don't even have words for it, disrespect, you know, Tim, of human life.
I totally agree with you. And but I think that part of what really strikes me is how this doesn't weigh on the moral conscience of people who do believe in abortion is that we are talking about flesh and farming for stem cells and things like that, but we're also talking about viable organs for transplant. If an organ is viable for transplant, how can you argue that that's not a life you took?
See, that's why the mainstream media is not covering this, Rick. It puts the lie to the lie that people have been telling themselves forever. I like what Rand Paul says. He when he talks about this, as well as his son, Ron Paul, as well as his son Rand, and he just says, "Look, I'm a doctor, and that's all I am. God created life, and I'm not going to decide whether it happens the instant of conception, or whether it happens, you know, 5 minutes before the baby enters the world." And I think, you know, he's very honest and open about that. And I think a lot of people feel that way. Even people who are in favor of abortion are not in favor of infanticide and this kind of despicable behavior. Rick, we're out of time, but thank you for your call.
Thanks, Tim.
Hey, we'll be right back. You know it. Just do what you do. Don't go anywhere.
Don't you think it's about time you treat yourself or someone you love to something very special? Well, Ozell Jewelers, the finest jewelry store in the High Desert, is known throughout the High Desert for having the largest variety of fine-looking jewelry and gifts for every special occasion. Ozell custom designs and manufactures their own jewelry, so you'll be able to find exclusive, one-of-a-kind, stunning styles you won't find anywhere else in Southern California. If you're looking for fine jewelry at unbeatable prices, Ozell Jewelers is the place to go. Show appreciation to that special person in your life with something special to cherish forever. Ozell Jewelers, voted best jewelers in the High Desert by the Daily Press regularly for years. Ozell Jewelers has been putting smiles on High Desert faces for over 30 years. Ozell Jewelers, in Rancho Cucamonga, Palm Desert, and Amargosa Road by Red Lobster in Victorville. Ozell Jewelers.
You know, it is the mission of this show to inform, educate, and engage. Other shows, their goal may be to entertain. Our goal is to engage you. Engage you into action. And when a good friend of mine contacted me and invited me to come speak about the SB 277 referendum at the conference that's going to be held this Saturday, and I heard the title, I was like, yes, not only am I there, but I want to talk about it. Engage California 2015 is going to be held in Chino, California, I believe, at the Calvary Chapel Chino Hills facility. And we'll get more into it from 9 to 5:30. We're going to get into it with my friend, Gina Gleason, who is a rock star when it comes to getting people involved. Gina, welcome to the show. Gina, welcome to the show.
Glad to be with you, Tim.
Oh, it's
great. Glad to be with you, Tim.
It is great to have you. So tell us the details just so we get them right. But it's this Saturday, July 18th, 9 to 5:30,
well,
right?
Actually, it starts on Friday evening at 7 p.m.
See, it's a
we
good
have
thing
one I'm... speaker that's coming in.
Oh, it's a good thing I brought you on. Frank... I'll let you talk about it.
Okay, great. We have Dr. Frank Turek coming in to Calvary Chapel, Chino Hills, Friday night, July 17th at 7 p.m. And it's a presentation that he takes throughout the state, throughout the nation, mostly the college campuses. and it's called I Do Not Have a Faith, Enough Faith to Be an Atheist. So he presents evidence for God. And so not only is he well-equipped to talk upon about this topic, he also likes to take questions from the audience. So we often have atheists coming out, young people who have questions about their faith or whatever it may be, a social issue.
And what time will that be?
That starts at 7 p.m.
And
in the church sanctuary.
So it's in the big sanctuary. How many people do you guys fit in that thing? I've gone to church there several times and always been blown away by how many people show up on Sunday morning.
Yeah, it's about 3,000, close to 3,000.
And you guys have how many services on Sunday?
Three services on Sunday and Wednesday evening service.
Wow. Wow. Okay. And then take us to Saturday morning. What's happening then?
Okay, Saturday, it's a full day. We start at 9 o'clock in the morning, and we go all the way till 5:30 in the evening. And we have a lineup of speakers. Some you may or may not have heard of.
Yeah, tell us who's coming.
But it's a full day. Yeah, well, first of all, we have our senior pastor, Jack Hibbs, and I think a lot of people in your audience may know him already, but a lot of people love him. And
oh, yeah. How could you not love a man who tells the IRS to bring it on, who is willing to engage in civic debate and willing to be involved in influencing our government? And understands his rights and is completely unafraid. The man is a patriot pastor. I just I love him. I could just say that as a brother.
Yes,
I love
definitely.
The man. He is phenomenal, and he's also on top of that. He is one of the best speakers I've ever heard in a pulpit. Period. He's one of the best speakers you'll ever hear.
I agree. That's my pastor. So
little bias there,
Pastor Jack. Yeah, we have again Frank Turek. His topic will be legislating morality. How many times have you heard someone say you can't legislate morality? Well, that's not true. Someone's morality is being legislated, so he's going to talk about that.
Well, we just covered the just unbelievably shocking stories coming out of Planned Parenthood that are all over the news,
right.
And you know. Like you said, somebody's morality is being legislated, and you're paying for it.
Exactly right. And some people just don't make that connection. So that's what he's going to do. People need to understand the connection between the culture and legislation. Because what comes out of Sacramento is a mandate. That's something that we have to live under as people usually. How we raise our kids and what they are exposed to in the public schools. And so there's a serious connection that people need to consider.
Okay, and who else are you going to have? You're having a panel, aren't you?
We're calling that our California panel, reporting from the front lines. And the people on this panel are people who have been fighting the good fight in California. We have Karen England, Executive Director of Capital Resource Institute based out of Sacramento. We have Jonathan Keller, the Executive Director of California Family Council. We have Dr. Jeff Myers, who is out of Colorado, but he's going to talk about what the marijuana laws have done to his state, because, you know, we have at least five initiatives scheduled right now with the Attorney General, and I don't know how many will be released, but we'll be dealing with recreational marijuana initiatives in the state of California. Then, of course, we have you, Tim Donnelly, who will be there to talk about your referendum on SB 277. Looking forward to that. And then myself.
Well, I am going to be excited. I am excited to be on such an august panel with yourself and others. And Gina, you have been a real warrior in the streets, organizing people, working on referendums, petitions, educating the public so that they can influence and, you know, contact their elected officials in an organized fashion so that it actually has impact. And I was talking to you about your church's, what you guys were doing, and how deeply upset you were about the passage of SB 277, and you know what your church has done to keep your members apprised of the facts is extraordinary.
Well, I mean, that's something that every church can do. We want to influence not only our community, but the entire state. And being involved in things like monitoring legislation, it's not illegal to do that. A church can lobby legislators, and we do that. We teach our congregation how to do that. So when SB 277 was making it through the various committee hearings, we were lobbying all the way through. And lo and behold, we did get the two Democratic legislators surrounding our city to vote no on SB 277.
Wow.
And I know it wasn't just us lobbying. There was a lot of people, but it doesn't hurt to have a church our size also lobbying.
Well, yeah, you guys have your own army. I mean, you're huge. But if somebody if somebody is listening right now and they go to a church that isn't deeply involved, if they come to this conference or if they invite their pastor or you know a deacon from the church or whatever, who might learn a little bit more about that whole topic, about civic engagement, because as I said at the beginning, a big part of what I'm trying to do with this show is get people engaged in an effective way so that instead of sitting around complaining about the outcome, they're part of deciding that outcome. So how do they register? How do they find the information, or is it too late?
Oh, absolutely not. They can come to the door and register that same day, whether it's Friday or Saturday. But they can go to the church website, Calvary Chapel, Chino Hills, and that web address is calvaryCCH.org. And they'll find a link right at the top of the website. Click on that link and it has information. Online registration has closed, but they are welcome to come and register on site.
Well, we'll encourage them to come. We'll encourage them to come to the church, because the bottom line is, let's keep it real simple. Every time I've ever Googled Calvary Chapel or put it into my maps, because I always forget how to get there, I always find it, because your building is, I think you can see it from the moon. Your campus is massive, just to fit all the cars in the parking lot. But everybody there is friendly. They'll direct you. If you don't know where the sanctuary is, just ask. But show up. I mean, we're living in historic times. We're living in times when I believe that a majority of people now understand that the government has become the greatest threat to their freedom, to their family, to their faith. And unless you're willing to do something about it, you know, you're just going to be sitting there complaining or living with the results. But you can learn at this conference, because you're going to have booths right throughout it where people can engage with different organizations that are doing different things. So whatever your issue is, you can learn how to become an effective activist and maybe start something in your community.
Well, that's exactly right. That's the purpose of this conference, and hence the name, Engage California. We don't want this to be a conference where we are just talking at you. We want to help you to not only understand the issues, but know how to be involved. And everyone can do something, whether you're an elderly person at home, whether you're a student in college, no matter what it is, everyone can take part in this culture war that we are engaged in and make an impact. And can you imagine what our state would be like if churches, if Christians, if citizens just got involved? We would have a different California.
Well, and I'm, as I'm working on this referendum, I'm meeting people from all over the state, and I've never seen such an awakening, because it's not just this particular issue. It is all the issues. It is the bathroom bill, you know, where the same-sex bathroom bill. It's the this new sex ed code that they're pushing through in a bill. And I was talking to liberal Democrat school teachers who are upset as parents over that bill. And when that happens, we become a movement and a force to be reckoned with. Gina, thank you for coming on the show today. Thanks for everything that you're doing. And we will put up a little bit of information at the Tim Donnelly Show about this conference and where it is, and in case anybody missed it, because we want people to be there. And by the way, if you're listening and you might want to just come out and meet me, that's fine. Please do. I will be there in the morning on Saturday, so you don't want to miss the it's the California panel, right?
Yes.
Okay, so if you're going to do nothing else, come on out to the California panel, and you might wind up leaving, coming in a citizen and leaving a citizen activist. Thank you, Gina, for all that you do, and we will look forward to seeing you on Saturday.
Okay, take care.
Okay, we'll be right back after this short break. Hey, you've heard me talk over and over again about Burro Canyon Shooting Park, which is arguably the greatest place on the face of the earth to exercise your Second Amendment. But it just got better, because if you mention the Tim Donnelly Show, they'll give you free stuff. You get a free hat, free coffee cup, while supplies last, if you mention Tim Donnelly Show. So get out there and get shooting. For directions or more information, call Burro Canyon at 626-910-1344.
Defending the fundamental freedom of parents to make informed decisions for their own children is a basic human right that should never be discarded. But it was. California's SB 277 denies children access to education and takes away a parent's right to choose. You don't have to be a parent to help, and only you can make a difference. Let's veto SB 277. Save the freedom of a parent's right to choose. To volunteer or donate, go to SB277referendum.com. SB277referendum.com. Do it. It now.
You are tuned in to the Radio Free California Network. I am your host, former California State Assemblyman Tim Donnelly, and I'm just feeling for the Nosconator in the production booth. She's just dying. If you have some magic fix on the allergies that occur out here in the high desert plains of Hesperia, she would be immensely grateful if something would work, because she's tried everything. Is there anything you haven't tried?
No.
What about Jack Daniels?
It doesn't work.
Well, it would be kind of hard to work in such a demanding environment under the influence of Jack Daniels. But Benadryl, all the over-the-counter things, I assume, have failed.
VapoRub. Benadryl, the nasal spray things that go up your nose and drip down your throat.
Oh, thank you for sharing that.
Yeah, all of those. No. It's the reason for the season.
I just want you to know that I feel your pain.
Thanks, whatever his name is.
Hey, you can always count on the Clintonator to come through and say just the right thing. But his wife, wow. It's scary how bad she is at politics. She's worse at politics than she was as Secretary of State. And she was a massive... somebody was describing what happened during her reign. And they said the whole world blew up and all of her allies turned on us. And it was like, wow, okay, yeah, let's make her president. You just can't make this stuff up. But, hey, back here, meanwhile, in California, I don't know if you've heard this, but there is a rumor that Jerry Brown of Jerry Brown, I don't shower fame. I want to build a damn train, but not a damn dam. And I sure as heck am never going to do anything about the freeways that you're driving on that are falling apart. But he has a gift that will keep on giving for all of you. He wants to raise the gas tax again.
I'm seriously about to move away.
No, people are
I don't know what you're going to do.
People are going. Here we are. Here we have gas prices approaching $5 a gallon. And Jerry Brown is dreaming about stealing even more of your hard-earned money because he needs to fund his socialist program so he can have this great legacy. And I don't know. I mean, what's the big deal? So let's say that you have to pay $5.50 for gas, but illegal aliens get to go to college and illegal aliens get to have sanctuary in California. They get to kill Americans. They get free food stamps and welfare payments. And California becomes the destination of choice, not only for illegals, but for lazy Americans that don't want to work, people who figured out we've got a great welfare state here in California. It's not one of those hands up kind of places. It's a full on handout for life. What's wrong with that?
Okay, but how is gas here $5 almost, and gas in Texas is $2.50? What's the difference?
Well, there's a huge difference.
Okay.
California has, you know how you've heard the term California only, like a California only vehicle?
Right.
Well, California wanted to be way out ahead of everyone else. So instead of a vehicle being essentially compliant with the requirements of all 50 states in terms of, it's always in terms of these environmental laws. And since most of them originate with the federal government, all you have to do is make it compliant for all 50 states to the least common denominator, right? Well, for California, 50 state compliance with EPA is not good enough. So that's why we have our own EPA called California Air Resources Board. And they're unelected. We've talked about them many times. We do the segment on the show called Putting California on a No-Carb Diet. But they have crafted their own blends of fuel. And look, you can call me a liberal maybe for 5 seconds because I'm going to say something controversial. I'm actually in favor of many of the moves that we made to clean up our air in California because when I first moved here, you couldn't see the mountains most days unless it rained. So we've taken some tremendous strides. We've crafted our own brand of fuel, and we have a summer and a winter blend, and it makes it really expensive if any of the refineries go out of production. And right now, we have refineries down, largely due to the fact, instead of having 5 refineries in California, which makes a lot of sense given that we're right on the coast and we're right near, you know, near the ports where all the oil comes in, we have like 2. So we'll get into this after this break. 323-746-TALK if you want to talk about gas. If you've been listening long to the Tim Donnelly Show, you know that we talk constantly about defending freedom and about defending our natural and inalienable rights. The Firearms Policy Coalition is a partner of the Tim Donnelly Show. But more than that, they're on the front lines every day in Sacramento and all across the state, in the courts, defending your Second Amendment right. That is a natural right that the government merely acknowledged in the Second Amendment. If you value your freedom, then you need to join Firearms Policy Coalition. Become a member. I'm a member, and I'm happy to support an organization that is doing such an incredible job. Go to joinfpc.org. The Tim Donnelly Show sent you. Or go to timdonnellyshow.com and click on the FPC link to make it easy. But whatever you do, join today. FPC.org. You always manage to slip this song somewhere in the show.
I love it.
Yeah.
There's a few of my favorites that I find appropriate spots for.
So do we have to talk about Trump now since you're burning for him?
I am. Trump.
What is the Trumpinator up to?
I know. I wish we were friends. Like, we talked every day, you know, hey, Trump, what's up?
Hey, look, I'm running a statewide referendum on a ballot proposition, okay, a referendum. So it basically puts a yes-no question, lets the people either affirm or veto a bill, okay? And I'm getting about 500 contacts an hour. Just people, just Facebook, Twitter. I can't keep up. It's my computer's blowing up. My phone's blowing up. Now, try to imagine.
Do I need to be your media specialist?
Be careful what you wish for.
True.
So
starting tomorrow.
But that's only one state. Imagine that times 50 states. And you have everybody and their brother trying to reach you. Everybody's trying to get you on air. Everybody wants to be your friend. Everybody wants to come and touch you and shake your hand and you know, touch the hem of your garment, basically, when you run for office. That's what happens. And I can't imagine that kind of...
Are you slightly comparing yourself to Donald Trump?
Not even.
Or are you just trying to...
No, I'm literally feeling for him. Because I'm trying to reach him. I'm one of those people. I'd love to have him on the show, but look.
I'm sure he has like 10 people managing, if not more.
Oh, that wouldn't be enough.
No way.
That wouldn't be enough. I mean, but you've got to have some, when this explodes like this and you become immensely popular, and I'm definitely not comparing myself to Donald Trump in that capacity. I mean, he has come on the scene in a way that we haven't seen in, I can't remember when, but one thing he does, he's built an organization. He has thousands, tens of thousands of people who work for him. So he knows how to manage a big organization. And look, that is not an easy thing. No matter how you measure it, it's just crazy. It's, anyway. But, hey, some exciting news on the, we've had a number of people on talking about what has happened in San Francisco with the sanctuary city policies that have decimated so many American cities. It's hard to even number how many lives have been lost. We have brought you a few of the most compelling, the most tragic stories, including the most recent one with 32-year-old Catherine Steinle. And it was funny. I was talking last week about how we need to do a massive rally in San Francisco against the sanctuary policies. Forget about rallying against people who are in the country illegally. Look, this is against the politicians who have betrayed the people. I agree with what Don Rosenberg said. He said they ought to be on trial. They literally ought to be co-defendants. Is that right? Defendants? Yeah. Yeah, in a criminal trial. Okay, so co-defendants. They ought to be sitting there in handcuffs. Kamala Harris, Gavin Newsom, the current mayor. What's his name? Ed Harris or something like that? Or is that's an actor? It's Ed Lee, I think. Then you've got that sheriff, Ross Murrah, whatever. Sanctuary Sheriff Ross, who thinks he's God's gift to the world and likes to lecture people. I think every one of them, and look, if my bill, AB 26, which would have brought that controversial Arizona law, SB 1070, to California, one of the major portions of it and why I supported it so much was very simple. It said if you are a city or municipality or county, any essential organization of government that is below the state level, and you choose to flout and ignore and reject federal law when it comes to cooperating on a law enforcement level with immigration authorities, then you can be sued by the citizens who are harmed. You can be held civilly liable for unlimited damages. And so that would mean that the family of Catherine Steinle could sue the city of San Francisco and its each individual political figures who supported these policies for gargantuan amounts of money, which then, of course, I don't think the ones against the actual officials would stick, but you do it anyway. You sue them jointly and severally. But if you could sue the deep pockets of San Francisco, you could bankrupt a city that refuses to cooperate and protect its citizens from killers and criminals that have no business being in this country illegally, who you right now are shielding from the appropriate consequences of their actions. We're not the ones. Nobody here put a gun to their head and said, come to the United States and commit the crimes that Americans refuse to commit. Said no one ever. I mean, it's that law right there. That would have terrified Los Angeles and San Francisco into actually upholding the law. And maybe the next Jamil Shaw, the next Catherine Steinle, the next Matthew Michael and Tony Bologna, the next Dominic Durden, the next Derek Rosenberg, doesn't happen. All because of the power of the free market system, where the threat of a lawsuit for putting in place stupid, irresponsible, dangerous policies cost you. And you got to hit these politicians. You got to hit these city leaders where it hurts. You destroy their budgets by getting $100 million settlement against them. And guess what? They're never going to do this again. And, of course, their insurance company, which is probably Warren Buffett, who insures everybody, you know, he's the insurance guru that insures the insurance companies. And you get something like $100 million or $200 million in damages against a city or a municipality or a county for engaging in this stupid political pandering that has cost Americans their lives. And you know what? That would turn policy around overnight. Period. End of story. That's why they didn't like SB 1070. That's why every city and county in California wrote a letter opposing it, because they don't want to have their money stolen. They have no problem stealing your money and giving it to the illegals and letting illegal aliens run amok. But when you come to hold them accountable, it's not a two-way street. What's good for the goose ain't good for the gander with them. But the good news is I was contacted this morning by a leader of a number of groups, and he's reaching out to a bunch of leaders up there. There is a massive rally being planned, and I'm going to call it the American Lives Matter rally, because that's what it is. American Lives Matter. Make that a hashtag. American Lives Matter. God, I'd love to see Obama's face when that takes place. And if there's any possible way that we can go there and cover it live, believe me, we would. So we will keep you posted on that news, and we will move on to some other topics and take your calls. right after this break. 323-746-TALK. That's how you can reach us. Stay tuned. Whether you're an experienced shooter or just buying your first gun, Turner's Outdoorsman has everything you need, along with a knowledgeable and friendly staff to help you find that perfect gear for your next adventure. Turner's now has 18 locations across Southern California, including a Victorville location right on Bear Valley Road. Be sure to check out the new Archery Pro Shops in the Victorville, Chino Hills, and Pasadena locations. If you're not sure what you're looking for, you can browse and shop their selection at turners.com. Be sure to check out their weekly specials and sign up to get them delivered directly to your inbox. Turner's is where I turn for all my firearms and ammo needs. Remember to tell them Tim Donnelly sent you, and you'll get an additional discount. Did you see this headline? Well, you probably can't see anything. You are so dying in there in the, you know what? Somebody send some relief to the Nosconator. Trump files personal financial disclosure with FEC, said net worth in excess of $10 billion. And I had the privilege of hearing him speak prior to him releasing this personal financial disclosure form. And I mean, he kept saying over and over, look, it's going to surprise you. It's going to shock you at how well I've done. And, you know, at first when you hear that and hear the way he talks, you're kind of put off and you're thinking, oh, it's kind of like bragging. Well, of course it is. But there's something so American.
He can brag.
Well, he's done it. He's done something.
Yeah.
What the hell has Hillary done?
Be with Bill Clinton.
What the hell? Well, that is a job. What about what's his face? Jeb Bush. What's his claim to fame? Being a Bush? That's it? Okay. Wow. Great job. That's too much. Good job.
Wait, I haven't done any research on this guy, JB. Is he actually a Bush?
He is the brother of George W. Bush.
Oh.
He is the son of George H.W. Bush, who was, I believe, our 41st president. And he is, and of course, the son of Barbara. But this is the press release from the Trump campaign. This report, meaning referencing the FEC, Federal Elections Committee report, this report was not designed for a man of Trump's massive wealth. For instance, they have boxes. Once a certain number is reached, they simply state 50 million or more. Many of these boxes have been checked. As for an example, if a building owned by Mr. Trump is now worth $1.5 billion with a B, the box is checked 50 million or more. So think about that.
Yeah, so they need to check that box a couple times.
No, but they can't. So all it's going to say is $50 million. So it's going to count as $50 million when in fact, if you actually, and the government doesn't like P&Ls. And anybody who owns a business knows what a P&L is. It's a profit and loss. They don't like balance sheets because then you look at indebtedness versus the equity that you actually own in the assets. And you come out with a true value of what you are worth. And of course, our government is oodles of trillions of dollars in debt. We're owned by foreign countries. And I'm just blown away that Trump is not, he's not pulling a Romney. He's not apologizing. He's not saying, gosh, you know, here's what a typical politician would do if they were really wealthy and their political consultants were telling them what to do. And I can't tell you how many people I know that are insanely successful in business. And then when it comes to politics, they listen to these people who've never won a race in their lives. And they take their advice verbatim. And they go out and they do whatever the political consultant tells them to do. So in the instance of Mitt Romney, it would be to come out to the microphone and say, well, you know, my wife and I, we actually can relate to you little people. We went to the grocery store the other day and we bought a gallon of milk. And golly gee willikers, we can't believe how expensive it is. It's like, dude, get a life. You have people who go to the grocery store. You don't even know what a gallon of milk costs, but a political consultant told you what a gallon of milk costs, and you don't even have it right because most of us can't afford to buy a damn gallon at a time. We're dealing with a pint or a half gallon, right? And you want to know why? Because the freaking gas prices have exploded here in California. That's how real people talk, right?
Yeah. I mean, we're real.
Okay.
Speaking of, real quick, I just got an email from Dennis in Apple Valley letting me know of a few things I can try for my allergies, so thank you.
Hmm. Anything you'd like? I was wondering why you were smiling in there, and I hadn't said anything particularly funny.
No.
So what does anything you can share? I mean, any,
yeah.
Yeah, like what?
Well, first he says, tell your female counterpart to try this.
Okay.
I like that. That's why I was laughing.
Okay.
But there's a prescription for me to get two pumps and then to try it a few minutes later with Afrin, follow up with that, and then I can build a resistance. So I will be trying this.
Oh, good. Well, thank you, Dennis in Apple Valley. I mean, you know.
It said it took him 17 years to figure out. I told you, I'm not being...
No, you're, I mean,
a girl
look,
about my allergies.
Look, I will say this in defense of the Noskinator. She is not a complainer. She does not belong in the crowd that complains about race or anything else. She just gets stuff done. Okay? And so, look, we are all, when I said that we feel your pain.
Wait, that wasn't right.
All right. When I said that I feel your pain. I meant that. I said it with my lower lip quivering.
Okay, Bill, I'll accept that.
I mean, but I said it on behalf of the entire audience. Because, look, no one likes to suffer, especially when you're trying to work and where there's a solution somewhere that somebody knows. That's one of the beautiful things about communications. Here we are on radio. You can, you know, believe me, if you say anything about your health on Facebook, which I did the other day, you will get a lot of advice. And some of it's really good. Some of it's very, very useful. And some of it's downright scary. But
drinking water?
Hey, look, I am on my third bottle of water. And I'm just going for five today because, look, I've got no caffeine in here to keep me pumped up. So, I don't know. I guess you guys out there are going to have to do that. So, maybe after this break, give us a call. 323-746-TALK. We'll take your calls. Wide open. Stay tuned.
Don't you think it's about time you treat yourself or someone you love to something very special? Well, Ozell Jewelers, the finest jewelry store in the high desert, is known throughout the high desert for having the largest variety of fine-looking jewelry and gifts for every special occasion. Ozell custom designs and manufactures their own jewelry, so you'll be able to find exclusive, one-of-a-kind, stunning styles you won't find anywhere else in Southern California. If you're looking for fine jewelry at unbeatable prices, Ozell Jewelers is the place to go.
Show appreciation to that special person in your life with something special to cherish forever. Ozell Jewelers, voted best jewelers in the high desert by the Daily Press regularly for years. Ozell Jewelers has been putting smiles on high desert faces for over 30 years. Ozell Jewelers in Rancho Cucamonga, Palm Desert, and Amargosa Road by Red Lobster in Victorville. Ozell Jewelers.
This is the Radio Free California Network. I am your host, former California State Assemblyman and gubernatorial candidate. You like that? I combine the gubernatorial with the governor, Tim Donnelly. And joined here, well, I'm on the other side of the protective glass barrier from the suffering Noskinator. Thanks again to Dennis in Apple Valley for giving her what Obama couldn't, some hope. I'm sorry, I can't help making fun. Hey, we're going to take a call from Mike on Planned Parenthood. Mike, welcome to the show.
There's a few things, you know, the Planned Parenthood. I've always kind of had an issue with that, but I mean, to sit there and, you know, we went away for, I guess, 3 days on one of these little cruises, and you know, we come back and we start hearing things like, you know, the body parts being used, and then the gas prices going up like almost a dollar a gallon. And I mean, it's amazing what can happen in 3 days. But, you know, it's how do you really understand where the, you know, this country is going when you look at how we were founded and how people wanted to try to defy when life begins? I mean, it's, you know, for anybody that's had a child, and you go in there and you listen to the heart rates, and they're doing them so early now. And you can also get these 3D versions, you know, where you can look and see the makeup of the face after just, you know, a couple of months. It's unbelievable to not think that this isn't a life. And with scientists who can take, you know, just a speck and say that it's a, you know, a form of life or something, you know, because it's a speck and it's moving or whatever else, we have a human that's being made that's already begun. I mean, the minute this happens, and I mean, I saw that, you know, thing Obama did with that church when he was first running for president. His answer to when life begins was, you know, above his pay grade, because it's a power, you know, above his. And it's like, well, when you're going to refer to when God says it, you know, that becomes a time of conception. So that pretty much answers the question right there. But, you know, whether or not people have a right to do it, well, of course, you know, gave them that right. But that still doesn't mean that someday they don't have to face judgment for it.
Yeah, there's a big difference between legal and moral, and between what is legally allowed and what is right. And what we're talking about with this case, Mike, is this is so sickening and so debasing of human life that it is. Beyond shocking. And I think, and we've had on the show, you remember when we had Nick Searcy on, the actor? Gosh, that guy's been on like 50 different movies and TV. And I saw him the other night. He's working on a movie about Gosnell, which never got the real coverage that it needed to, because you're talking about people committing murder. We're not talking about abortion anymore. We're talking about murder. And here, we're not talking about whether you're for abortion or against abortion. We're talking about whether you're for chopping up children who have died. Because once they're out in the world, I assume this is the body of a child. And they have damaged particular parts to inflict the death of this child in order to sell the body parts. I mean, that's it.
It's putting us into a Franken, you know, Stein, you know, type of thing. Like years back when they had talked about how they were going to start cloning things, and it's like, well, we're not going to be able to clone humans. And it's, well, come on. We know at some point that's going to be getting done. You know, and there was a movie a long time ago that came out called The Island. where they hit all those people. I don't know if you guys have seen that, but they were just basically raising people to be body parts for rich people so that they could take, you know, parts that would have their own gene, you know, their own basic makeup, so it'd be perfect fit. So they needed an arm, they had one. They needed an eye, you know, a heart, they could live for longer. And it's, you know, we're watching things nowadays that doesn't make all this stuff so far-fetched. And how do you, a doctor has a right to do everything he can to save a patient. And I don't understand how any doctor can sit there and say, okay, well, you know, let's go ahead and just terminate this right now. And I mean, I know there's cases out there where people are raped and it's very hard to deal with. My best friend for, you know, years was a product of rape. His mother, you know, had a hard time in life. She never really went outside. But, you know, as a result of the tragedy that happened, you know, he was around and he still is around. And it's, you know, hard for her. It was, you know, but he is having, you know, a good life. And, you know, you can actually, you know, give the child up. You can find somebody that will take that child and raise it. And you're looking at 9 months that you're going to have to carry this. And, you know, it's instead of doing Planned Parenthood to say, you know, we could just take that thing out of you, you know, and get rid of it and it'll go away. Well, number one, it's never going to go away. It's always going to be in your mind. But what won't be in your mind is that 20 years from now, you'll be wondering what life would have been like had you not done that. That child could still be alive. You're going to have to go through therapy. You're going to need help. People are going to help you deal with what happened to you, whether you keep that child for those 9 months or whether you abort that child right there on the spot.
Mike, I have massive regrets at times over whether to eat a cheeseburger or not. Whether to drink a soda or not, you know, because I know the implications. I know the consequences are. My wife's going to get mad at me. I'm going to look bloated. I'm going to gain weight, and I'm not doing my health any good, right? So
right.
I can't imagine. We have regrets over, you know, maybe not going and talking to a person when we're younger in life and looking for a mate or whatever, you know, all of that stuff. So we regret some of the simplest, most trivial things. I can't imagine, knowing how I feel about my children, I cannot imagine how a thinking, feeling human being who has had an abortion truly feels. I mean, I can't, because I've never had that. But it has to be very traumatic, and it has to affect you for the rest of your life.
Well, I can tell you this. You know, I didn't find out until about 26 years later that I had a child that I would have had if not for the abortion. I was never told about it, had no clue. And it, to me, it was as devastating 26 years later as it would have been the same day I would have found out, because it's something that, to me, was, you know, it was the loss of my child. And, you know, the person, you know, that did it regrets it, you know, and, you know, it's just, you know, she has to live with it, and I don't talk about it with her, and it's kind of an off-subject thing because it's over, she's changed her way in life, but... You know, it's when we talk about, you know, the woman's right, it's her body and all the rest of that, I think sometimes maybe there should be a consideration of the fact that that isn't just hers. I mean, in a case of like a marriage or where two consenting people did this, and whether it was a mistake or not, they made this child. And, you know, to sit there and say that the man who has a part of that, that's 50% of his body in there that's being made, and to say that he doesn't even have the opportunity to say, like I would have said, just go ahead and have the baby, I'll take it and go away, and you'll never see us again. I mean, to sit there and say that we have absolutely no rights, even though she gave us the permission to be there, to do what we did, to get her into the condition, it's like we should have a little bit of a say, at least, in the fact that she's going to terminate a part of us, because there's a part of me just as much as a part of her. But
well,
we've never gotten to that point, and we probably never will, because it's always about now.
Because the courts intervened, just like they did recently with the whole gay marriage. They put an end to it. No, we're not going to have any more votes. We're not going to listen to the people. You know, to heck with you. You're too dumb. You're too backwards. It's taking too long. So the courts are just going to make new law, and you're going to have to comply. And of course, that's why issues tend to remain deeply controversial, because they weren't decided by the people.
Right. And it's, you know, it's sad. I mean, I just hope that, you know, people really start to think more. And the people that have actually gone through this, you know, I know it's hard for them to talk about it, but, you know, it's like your AA meetings and things like that. It's it's the people who have gone through the bad times that speak out to tell the people that are getting ready to go through it what it's like in the future. And hopefully, you know, not Planned Parenthood, I've heard so much about how they just basically push you one way. And you know, that's just what they do. They think that the best thing to do is, you're not ready, then get rid of it. It's okay. You know, you're only a couple months. It's no big deal. You know, it's, there should be people out there that have suffered, and, you know, and hopefully there's people with the courage to do more of that and say, this is what's going to happen to you. Because I can tell you right now, I would love to walk into my other room and sit down with my 24-year-old son or daughter, whoever it would have been, and had a conversation with them and, you know, at least had something to do with the life that I created, rather than have a phone call one day, 20-something, you know, 28 years later to say, well, you know, there actually was one, but, you know, it didn't happen. And, you know, then it becomes something that, you know, eats at me, but, you know, it eats at the woman too. And, you know, for a guy's standpoint and for all the women out there, if you're, you know, thinking about doing that, you know, not all men are dogs. Some of us have a lot of, you know, respect in life and could treat that kid very well, raise him very well, give a guy a chance, and, you know, hopefully, you know, the child will live, because that's the greatest thing in the world is watch that baby come out. And you never know, when that baby's born, you may see something that you didn't know was ever going to come into your heart. You may find out that, you know, the greatest thing you ever did was allow that child to be born. So you're going to want to keep that child and not give it away. And it's there, you know, there's no wrong there, because you don't have to worry about saying, I shouldn't have done it, because it's there. Oh, you know, if it's adopted, it's going to have a good life. But you can't go backwards and say, nah, I think I'm just going to try and have it redone and get that baby back. When you do it, it's gone, and that's it. It's gone.
Mike, thank you for your call, and thank you for sharing a really, really painful story and talking about the real consequences of a choice that most people never, nowadays, don't give a thought. So, hey, we're going to thank you for calling in.
All right. All right, have a good night, guys.
I don't even know what to say after that. That speaks for itself. 323-746-TALK. If you got something to say, take your call. Whether you're an experienced shooter or just buying your first gun, Turner's Outdoorsman has everything you need, along with a knowledgeable and friendly staff to help you find that perfect gear for your next adventure. Turner's now has 18 locations across Southern California, including a Victorville location right on Bear Valley Road. Be sure to check out the new Archery Pro Shops in the Victorville, Chino Hills, and Pasadena locations. If you're not sure what you're looking for, you can browse and shop their selection at turners.com. Be sure to check out their weekly specials and sign up to get them delivered directly to your inbox. Turner's is where I turn for all my firearms and ammo needs. Remember to tell them Tim Donnelly sent you, and you'll get an additional discount.
Defending the fundamental freedom of parents to make informed decisions for their own children is a basic human right that should never be discarded, but it was. California's SB 277 denies children access to education and takes away a parent's right to choose. You don't have to be a parent to help, and only you can make a difference. Let's veto SB 277. Save the freedom of a parent's right to choose. To volunteer or donate, go to SB277referendum.com. SB277referendum.com. Do it now. Was that what track was that?
It's called Broke Record by Eric Church.
I don't think I ever heard of him.
You probably haven't.
Is that like country.
It's country.
Country rock. Yeah,
it's a pop country.
You gotta play more of that. Hey, we're gonna go right to the phones. Jim from Victorville wants to comment. Jim, welcome to the show.
Hello, Tim.
Great having you on.
You know, I was listening to you speak to the other gentleman about the abortion issue, but I watched that video of that Dr. Deborah Mengele.
Right.
And it was so reminiscent of the Nazis sitting in that resort in 1942 or 43, sitting around talking about the final solution, or Che Guevara and Hemingway having a lunch over while they watched executions.
Yeah.
I mean, this kind of thinking behavior is things that we hung people for at Nuremberg after World War II. And to think that someone would actually use a partial birth abortion type procedure to selectively get a liver.
Yeah, it's Jim. It's how is that not murder? How is that not murder for in order to traffic the parts? And if the child isn't a life, then how are the organs viable?
That's right.
And if the organs are viable, how is it not murder?
It is murder.
Yeah,
I mean, you can understand a young girl or a mom, or they get in some situation and they're desperate and they don't know what to do. You can excuse that.
Well, and that's one of the reasons that I support pregnancy alternative centers, where a young girl can go. It's not funded by the government. Yes, the girl knows abortion's an option. They talk about that with her, but they don't refer, and they'll give her all of the help and counseling she needs without pushing her to do that. And yet this is done with your tax dollars and my tax dollars. And I mean, to see and hear, you have to watch the video, don't you agree? And see the attitude of the girl. She's sitting there drinking wine and eating like it's nothing.
Well, and then they say, oh, well, it's selectively edited. Well, if you watch the unedited version, it's just as bad.
Yeah, but I mean, the fact that she is saying what she is saying, I don't care how you edit it. No one put words in her mouth. And the bottom line is, you made the correct comparison, calling her Mengele. I mean, this is, you know, sometimes when you're in talk radio, it's really hard to, you want to be careful never to just go straight to a comparison to Hitler.
Right.
Which everybody does when they first start talking about politics for some reason. But this is something that we would put people on trial, or we would have, and we did in Nuremberg. This is something that is it goes beyond a crime. This is a human rights. I don't know. I don't even know the words.
This is absolutely, and I am not without my own sin in that. I've been in situations where a spouse, and I thought it was okay, and it wasn't. And the only thing that has saved me is, of course, Jesus.
Well, that's a Jim. That's a tough thing. I can't even imagine. I was even saying, I can't imagine what you go through thinking about that, because, I have 5 sons, and I can't imagine what I would do if anything happened to any of them. And you're right. This is a and nobody talks about this anymore. You're not allowed to.
No, and I've been convicted of it, and I, just through the, the saving grace of the Lord that saved me. But this is a whole different level of evil, I think. This is planned harvesting of children's organs for profit. How much lower can we go in this country? And I firmly believe, and I'm not a crazy Christian or anything like that, but I believe that this is being brought out for us to see what the American people are made of. Because if we don't do something about this, it's not going to be good for the United States. Or it's not going to be good for this country. People are not... God is going to withhold any blessing that he has on this country.
Jim, these are crimes against humanity. And they're crimes against God. Against our Maker, who gave us the gift of life. And this is a debasing, degenerate behavior that has no place in humankind. Hey, we're out of time, Jim, but thank you for calling in with, and thank you for sharing your story. I think it's important.
There is redemption.
There is redemption. Absolutely. Well, thanks for your call, Jim.
Okay.
Hey, you know, we don't avoid the difficult topics on this show, and we let you talk. So, give us a call after this break if you have something to say about this, because it's obviously struck a nerve with people. Stay tuned. Hey, if you like shooting as much as I do, you've probably been to a lot of ranges. Unless you visited Burro Canyon Shooting Park, you've never seen anything like it. On the way there, you'll find yourself taking pictures as you traverse the majestic Azusa Canyon and wind your way up into the Angeles National Forest. With over 600 acres, including 19 private ranges, there's something for everyone. There's rifle and pistol ranges for beginners, right up to advanced shooters. And there's plenty of spaces to shoot sporting clay. You can make a family day of it, or you can bring a group for team building exercises. Bring a picnic lunch. On the weekends, they provide lunch. And don't worry, they always have ammo in case you forget yours or run out. One thing I can guarantee is that once you visited my friends at Burro Canyon Shooting Park, you'll be hooked and you'll keep coming back. BurroCanyon.com is their website, or call them at 626-910-1344. 626-910-1344. Welcome back to the Tim Donnelly Show. We broadcast live every weekday, 3 to 6 p.m. We stream live at timdonnellyshow.com, and you can connect with us at Facebook, Twitter, email, or even, dare I say it, the good old-fashioned telephone, 323-746. Talk is our number, and we've been talking with people all over the listening area about the, I think Jim nailed it. It's not Planned Parenthood. That's the worst name possible for an abortion mill. It is planned harvesting. That's what they're doing. And it's, it's inhuman. It's a crime against humanity, what has gone on. And this has been funded by you, whether you like it or not, whether you agree with it or not, whether you're pro-life or pro-choice has nothing to do with it, because this is after that question is already settled. Abortion is legal in the United States. That's a fact. But harvesting organs and terminating the pregnancy, or how can you say that these organs are viable and not have it be a life? That's a real conundrum. So when you terminate a life, as opposed to people like to use euphemisms, there's no other word for it. And this is happening right here, right now. And it's... I wish I was making this up. I wish I had not heard and seen and read and watched this video and heard another human being say the kinds of things. And this isn't new. This has been going on for a long, long time, but they got caught. And they got caught in a big way. And this is going to explode because people want to know what's going on. And I think Jim nailed it. How we react to this as Americans determines what kind of country we are. Marty from Hesperia, welcome to the show.
Hi, Jim. How are you doing?
I am doing great. It's great to have you on.
Well, a few years ago, I was at a protest where they were, you know, on both sides of this. I was sitting there jumping up and down and hollering that I was, you know, pro-choice, but my choice was adoption in all circumstances. And this crazy lady, I'll, you know, try to clean it up a little bit, but she comes up.
Yeah, we don't want to have to dump you, Marty. I got my finger hovering above the dump button.
No. I'm going to keep it clean. So.
All right.
Anyway, she's saying, well, how many have you adopted? And I go, well, let's expand it a little bit to my whole family. I go, my grandfather was adopted, my mother-in-law was adopted, I adopted one, my brother adopted two, and my sister put one up for adoption. How about you, lady? She just stood there with her mouth hanging open.
Wow. Well, I have a sister who, when she was just about to get married and they could barely afford rent, they were actually taking care of a baby whose mother was on crack and in jail. And they were, I think, the foster family, or I don't know how it all worked out, but basically this little child who was born prematurely, her name is Jasmine, who is now my niece. My sister fought all the regulations and worked tirelessly and had prayer warriors praying not only for this baby's health, but also she raised the resources to provide diapers because once the mother got out of jail and she was on welfare, when the welfare check ran out mid-month, there were no diapers for the baby for the rest of the month. And my sister would provide those. And ultimately, she won the right to adopt this child, raised her as her own. She now has, I lose track because I think she had like six kids after that. So I believe they're a family of seven kids. And by the way, I have 14 brothers and sisters. So I have a right to not be able to keep track of quite all of them. But that young lady, we just saw a picture on Facebook of her the other day, got her first car. She's like 18 years old. She's smart as a whip. She's one of the most best-mannered kids you'd ever meet. And by the way, they always say that so-called, let me put air quotes, crack babies are never going to be normal. Well, she is better than normal. And my sister didn't have the resources, but she was, yes, a born-again Christian, a Christian conservative who puts her money where her mouth is. And you're right. You raise the hypocrisy of those who can't see the value of life. And I think we've cheapened life so much in this country that maybe what's happened isn't going to shock that many people. Marty, I'm worried about that.
Yeah. And the other thing that I like to do is I like to interrupt their little, you know, play on words, trying to make it, you know, so sterile. And you know, I say, how can you possibly, in good conscience, butcher a baby? Oh, well, yeah, they just stumble over that. No, you know, it's just it sells it. No, at the point of conception, that is a living human being. How can you justify butchering it? And I go the rounds with a lady that I work with. Oh, my God, I make her so mad. And when I first found out about this, I went into the office and talked to another gentleman that believes like me, and she just went nuts because, you know, she is just all for, you know, terminating pregnancies. And I just, it bothers me beyond words because my son that I adopted was my first. And I tell you what, it was the best thing I ever did in my entire life.
How old is your son now, Marty?
22.
Wow. Wow. And what does he do?
He's a security guard.
Great. You know, as a parent, whenever you can say your kid has a job, it's believe me, it's something to be proud of. But not only that, but you raised him, and I'm sure you raised him with the values that you were raised with. And look, that life, you made a massive difference in that life. And here's the thing that I would encourage people to do. Look, I don't believe in using the government to force everybody else to believe the way I do. I believe in putting my money where my mouth is. I support pregnancy alternative centers, the ones that are right now under assault in the California state legislature. They want these groups that are funded by individuals who are almost all pro-life activists. They want them to be forced to refer abortions and promote government-sponsored abortions that are done by Planned Parenthood. And I'm hoping maybe that this news, maybe one of the side effects and the silver lining will be that bill is killed and pregnancy alternative centers can continue to do the good work they do with private funds, giving people all of the tools that they need to have a successful pregnancy and the support that they need, you know? And I think that right there is one of the most powerful forces right now for good. And of course, anything that's a powerful force for good in California becomes a target for the Marxist progressives that want to control everything.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, look at the way that they've, you know, forced so many people, you know, because the father's in the picture, they get next to nothing. But if the father's not, they get everything but their farm. You know, I mean, it's ridiculous the way that the government is encouraging and discouraging an actual real relationship.
Yeah. I mean, people always say, let's get the government out of our bedrooms. Why don't we get them out of our lives? Get them out of our relationships. Get them out of financing and replacing the father in the home and interfering with the natural family, which comes from the Creator. I mean, he who created us created a natural order of things, and the government is continually interfering and interrupting and essentially trying to replace they're trying to replace God with the government. And we need God back in our country in a serious way. Marty, we got to go, but thanks for the call.
All right, you have a great day.
Same to you. Hey, if any of this stuff resonates with you and you want to do something about it, you ought to check out that Engage California 2015 conference this Friday and Saturday at Calvary Chapel, Chino Hills. Look, you can Google Calvary Chapel, Chino Hills. It's very, very easy. And you can find all kinds of organizations you can get involved with. You can actually go out and engage in the political debate or in the faith-based organizations that are trying to make a difference in people's lives. Because, you know, it really breaks my heart to even talk about what was on that video. It breaks my heart. I came off air two breaks ago and literally it just wanted to break down. It's so painful and sickening to even imagine that human beings could do such things to each other. And I don't know. We just can't deny reality. Yeah, play the music. Get me off air. Good job. We'll be right back. Hey, if you find yourself in my hometown of Twin Peaks, don't leave without stopping by the Grill at the Antlers Inn. It's right in the heart of Twin Peaks. They serve dinner every night. They're right there at Highway 189 and Bear Springs Road. They have the best steaks, the best sushi. No matter what you have, make sure you call ahead for a reservation. 909-336-2600. 909-336-2600. And tell them Tim Donnelly sent you.
I can feel it coming in the air tonight. Oh Lord. And I've been waiting for this moment for all my life. Oh Lord. Can you feel it coming in the air tonight? Oh Lord.
Why'd you turn off the music? I love that.
I know, but it's over.
Oh my God. Someday, I know it's probably illegal. I can't, other than the music, we have absolute permission to play the entire song, like from Madison Rising. We can't play the whole song, but that is such a great song. And anyway, back to the reality of California. It's you know, I'm trying to figure out where this is all going to go, because I don't think we have ever seen this kind of unfettered anti-government sentiment since the revolution. And I mean, right now, let's just take California. There are millions of Californians who are literally in a fight for their lives, for the ability to be able to feed their families. And it's the government that has mismanaged or wasted natural resources like water. Water's a simplest example. In order to support some kind of an agenda, but an agenda that has nothing to do with actually the real purpose of government, which is defending, securing, and safeguarding our natural and inalienable rights. Life, liberty, pursuit of happiness, freedom, whatever you want to call it. Property rights. The government's become the greatest threat to those things. And every day, it is looking to grow inch by inch and encroach on more and more territory that has always belonged to the individual. Why do we need the government to come in and mandate forced vaccinations? Everyone must be vaccinated. If you are not vaccinated, to hell with worrying about the side effects. You don't get a choice about that. If you don't shoot up your kid with 35 rounds of toxins. Yes, vaccines are toxins, just like any other drug. Anything you introduce into your body, any foreign chemical, is a toxin to you. But, you know, the old saying, what doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Yeah, for most people. Sure. But why is the government, in response to a measles outbreak that had nothing to do with the unvaccinated or selectively vaccinated population, decide it's going to stamp out religious and parental rights? Because that's for sure. That's done. We have stamped out, wiped out, trampled on your rights. And I don't care what you think about vaccines. This is about freedom. This is about a fundamental right of a parent to ultimately make that decision, that informed decision. That ain't an easy decision. I mean, you heard earlier today people talking about choices they made earlier in their lives. In Mike's case, he didn't even know about a choice that had been made without his knowledge. But he suffers the consequence. And here we have tens of thousands of people whose lives are going to be turned upside down because the government wanted to react and grow itself and exercise its power and remain relevant and significant and show people it's in charge and in control of everything. All they've done is make people feel safer. SB 277 doesn't make you safer. If you go to Disneyland and an illegal alien or a foreign legal tourist comes in and carries the measles virus in there again, you're going to get it. SB 277 ain't going to keep you safe, period. And if your kid is vaccinated and immunized, then your kid is now immunized and inoculated against these diseases that we've wiped out. But it is Jerry Brown's policies, the same idiot governor that signed this bill that we're having to spend all this time undoing, invites millions of illegals. As a matter of fact, did you hear what he said? He said, any illegal alien anywhere in the country, come to California, we'll take care of you. Because you know what? They're undocumented votes to him. They're future Democrat voters. And that's why California is in the state that we're in. And I love this state. And I'm going to continue to fight for this state. If you want to join me, go to SB277referendum.com. Sign up to help me join with thousands of others who are standing up for personal liberty, freedom, parental rights. And you know what? I don't do this show by myself. I want to thank all of you for listening, first of all. I want to thank my wife for letting me do this. I want to thank Bethany Nosko, the Noskinator, who is feeling better just with the news from Dennis's cure, Cassie Cassidy, the intrepid guest booker, Sean McNeil, our technological wizard, and you, along with our sponsors who make this show possible. And we will be right back 3 to 6 p.m. every weekday. God bless you and Godspeed. Tim Donnelly Show out.
Defending the fundamental freedom of parents to make informed decisions for their own children is a basic human right that should never be discarded. But it was. California's SB 277 denies children access to education and takes away a parent's right to choose. You don't have to be a parent to help, and only you can make a difference. Let's veto SB 277. Save the freedom of a parent's right to choose, to volunteer or donate. Go to SB277referendum.com. SB277referendum.com. Do it now.
Hey, you've heard me talk over and over again about Burro Canyon Shooting Park, which is arguably the greatest place on the face of the earth to exercise your Second Amendment. But it just got better. Because if you mention the Tim Donnelly Show, they'll give you free stuff. You get a free hat, free coffee cup, while supplies last, if you mention Tim Donnelly Show. So get out there and get shooting. For directions or more information, call Burro Canyon at 626-910-1344.